was it like? How do you spend free time in your hobbies?
Yay!
So be ready to share the personal, right?
No, thank you.
Information. What is the color of your toothbrush?
What color is it?
Oh my god.
Maybe green.
You get zero.
Scam.
Okay. So, good evening.
Ohio.
Good evening, my students. My name is, you know my name.
Who was what? Who was
you? Okay, so, do they need to give me the mark sheets? No? Okay. Okay, guys, I know where you're from, so I don't want to ask you this. I want to ask you.
I come from a planet called.
Stop.
Yeah.
Stop. Stop.
Okay, you're making good jokes. We have not much time to talk about it.
Well, watching anime, playing games, and watching TV to watch more anime, and watch science stuff because I'm a nerd, and then watch gaming stuff because I'm also a absolute professional gamer, and that's all. I never go out.
So you're addicted to this place, right? Watching, gaming.
Yes.
Nothing real. Okay, tell me about.
Sit at home and do nothing. I'm lazy.
Okay, tell me about your favorite game.
My favorite game. That's the hard question.
Okay, what kind of games you prefer? What genre?
I play sandbox game, JRPG, and all kind of stuff. Every famous game.
Yeah, well, famous games are strategies, you know, like Star Trek. Age of Empires, do you play
yeah,
those?
Yeah, I do play Age of Empires. Okay. A lot, actually. I always use cheat because I'm lazy.
Yeah, but for a multiplayer game, you cannot use cheat.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is your favorite TV show?
My favorite TV show. I watch a lot of TV shows. Let me think.
Okay, what kind of TV shows you prefer?
Well, I watch every single Marvel TV show and DC TV show, and also a lot of drama TV show.
Oh,
I don't want to talk about the other stuff.
Okay. We give you.
Yes.
Tell me about one of your hobbies.
Hobbies.
Okay, tell me about listening to music.
And also reading books and watching films.
Yeah, just choose any hobby you like.
Yeah, I'll choose music, listening to music.
Okay, tell me about this. Tell me.
My favorite type of music is indie. And I don't have my favorite artist because I like songs. I don't follow, I don't support it, I just like the songs.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm on YouTube, I find them on YouTube and I listen to it and I enjoy it.
Mm-hmm.
And I would love to learn to play a musical instrument, but I don't have time.
Yeah, so how do you find? If you don't have a like favorite artist, how do you find songs on YouTube?
I just try to find some lyrics, some channels that make lyrics of songs, and I try to find the songs who has the better lyrics and the features.
Okay, so. What keywords you use to look like? What keywords you use on YouTube to look for indie songs? Like what keywords you use? You know, like when you go to YouTube, you must write something to search, right? The keywords, the words you use to search for indie music.
I usually search like one of the famous artists. Indie Vietnamese indie artists, and they will have some recommend songs for me, and I try to choose one.
Okay. Next part. No. We will have make you speak for 1 minute without interruption.
Yay.
So anybody who stops, you will get.
What do you mean?
I can stop you. Bye.
Okay, so the point is, I will give you two, one by one, I will give you two different pictures and different pictures for you. So, stop speaking in the I'm giving you two photographs, and you must talk about those photographs for 1 minute. And later, like, when while he will be talking about photographs, you also should check it out, and after he finishes, you make some comments, like, about photographs or about what you think about him. Okay, so you can just talk about your reaction to these photographs, about your opinion and your feelings, emotions. And you must compare and contrast them. Anything that can keep you talking for 1 minute. Doesn't look so good, but this is tornado. Yeah, this one is tornado. This is
camera. Ah, so these are both like very bad and serious natural disease that is not really like common.
Yeah, like you talk about your reactions, like what do you think, what does it make you feel?
I feel sorry for the people that live in this area, and because they are both very destructive, like the volcano, the tornado can easily, with its like powerful wind, it can suck everything that is near it. So every house and stuff will be destroyed, and a lot of people died, and I mean, I like people died, but yeah. And also the volcano. Like, I have seen like a movie about it, and that's when there's like people living around this area, they have a chance of staying back there is not very easy, because when the magma from volcanoes beat up, it will burn everything in its way. Also, like, what is it called? I forgot. But, right, to answer this question?
Yeah, I can also
I think the natural disaster that is easier to repair is the natural, is the volcanic eruption. Because the magma moves very slowly, but so when you see it, you have to leave the stuff behind, but you can still survive because you can run away. But the tornado is maybe hit like very surprisingly, and you cannot run. Your stuff gone, and you die, and everything gone. Yay.
Good.
I like that.
Do you make some comments?
I think that just talking
is weird.
You like dying too?
So you think tornado is easier? What do you think about which of these disasters easier to prepare for?
I also think that volcanic eruption is easier to prepare for because this eruption happens like very surprisingly but slowly, and you can run away from the tornadoes. It can come any time, but you cannot predict. And its power is very strong.
Yeah.
And yeah, the water can dip everything, and you can die.
The water?
Yeah, we are not geologists here, so we're just trying to
people to survive in the really hot weather like this, and they can be more, they can avoid the rain, because in this area there is hardly rain, and in the South Pole, South Pole is a very cold place, and only scientists choose to live in this place because there are many mysterious and interesting things about wildlife they can learn when they do research here. And there are also many natural resources like petrol or coal can be found here. That's why many countries on the world send their scientists go to this place and build up stations and do researches despite the weather.
I actually kind of agree with her, because there are still people living in the desert, because even though there's hardly water there, there's still lake and stuff that you can drink, and also food from the animals, and some plants still grow there. But in like Antarctica, there's no land, as I learned from geometry. Even though there's a lot of natural resources, but just coming there costs a lot of money. So there's very little people live there.
Okay, now the current spark, we will have collaborative talk.
I don't like.